One group that criticized the U.S. Russia agreement is the Free Syrian Army. They have been fighting the Assad government for more than 2 years. I spoke earlier today to rebel leader General Salim Idris. He connected with us via Skype from inside Syria. General, thank you for joining us. I want to start by asking you for your reaction to this new U.S.-Russia broker deal that calls for the seizure and destruction of chemical weapons.
Everything is very clear. There is a war crime. There is a criminal regime. There is a murderer president. But after the what is so-called Russian initiative, we think now that there is a very little chance for strikes. What we can say, we, the Syrian people, on behalf of the Syrian people and on behalf of the revolutionary forces, that we are very frustrated because of what is going on and because the international community is not caring any more about the victims.
President Obama said a few weeks ago that he would send arms to help you. Have you received those arms?
We are receiving now many kinds of support from our American friends. But I can't talk in media about, in detail, about military support. You excuse me, please. You know, this is very critical, and I can't talk about it.
General Dempsey, the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, said he didn't think the side the U.S. has chosen is necessarily ready to promote their interest and ours. That's the way he put it. Do you feel like you're ready now?
We are ready in the Free Syrian Army for everything. And we appreciate and we welcome any kind of help from our friends in the United States. Under our command, we have a very well-organized brigades and battalions who are working and fighting for freedom, for democracy.
There is some concern, however, in the U.S. that some of the arms, if they were provided to the rebels, would end up in the hand of jihadis. What do you say to that?
We are ready in the Free Syrian Army to give you any kind of guarantee that you need to assure you that any kinds of weapons, ammunition that you are going to deliver to us will be in the right hands, the hands of my officers, of my soldiers, of my fighters who are really moderate, who are fighting for democracy, for freedom, who are against extremism, and all other jihadi or extremist groups will not have any access to these kinds of support. And now we don't share information with them. We don't support them. We don't give them ammunition and weapons.
As you know, General, the U.S. has said they will not endorse direct military intervention in this civil war. That's what the president has said, and I know some of your friends in Congress disagreed with that, but that's the last thing that we heard from the president and from Secretary Kerry. So what do you want the U.S. to do, given that limitation?
They can organize a no-fly zone over the country with the support of the Western countries, with the support of the Security Council, especially now. I think it is more easy after the report, after the last report. In the last report, there is a crime. They can help us doing strikes using long-distance rockets, using Air Force, and not directly to send fighters on the ground.
But, General, as you know, the UN report doesn't actually say the government is behind these attacks, which leaves open the possibility, as some say, that your folks are behind them.
Oh, my God, please. Do you think that the FSA has the ability to launch chemical materials? We said many, many times we don't have chemical materials. And as you know, Secretary Kerry said very clearly that our friends in the United States, they know where the rockets launched from and where they landed and who gave the order. We know who gave the order. We have evidences. And the international community, all of our friends in the international community, they know that the regime used the chemical materials.
I have one final question for you, sir. Do you think, given the report from the UN and the deal that was cut in Geneva, that you are any closer today to your goal of overthrowing Assad?
I think we are very close to throw out Bashar and to collapse the regime. And I have the hope to collapse the regime tomorrow. We hope that our friends in the United States help us and our friends in Europe, because the Russians and the Iranians are helping the criminal regime.
General Salim Idris, thank you.